Let the waves of calm wash over me. And go.
That's not how that works.
Oh, Gamora!
Since when do you meditate?
I don't, but desperate times and all. Stuff's been a lot lately.
I get it. Allah help me, do I get it.
So, how do you use this, then? In case, you know, Rocket asks.
Well, for one, it isn't about just holding it. You also need a comfortable place to sit, where you can be relaxed but alert, and focus on your breathing. Then you practice. A lot.
Yeah. That sounds like a lot more work than I was hoping for.
Anything worth doing tends to be.
So how do you do it?
Focus was something Thanos beat into us early on. But it wasn't until I lived with the priests of Pama that I realized how limited his version of meditation really was.
How did you end up living with the priests of Pama? They're not exactly your kind of crowd with the whole pacifism thing.
Mantis introduced me to them last year when I needed to heal. They helped me in ways I didn't think were possible.
Helped? How?
I guess you could say I was broken. Thanos, the war, working as an assassin. It'd take a toll on you. By the time Mantis brought me there, I was ready to give up. I mean, I was miserable. Convinced I was beyond redemption or worth. I truly believed I deserved to die.
But you didn't. Die?
No. There was this boy there. Akan.
The one you hugged in the village.
Akan was like me. Lost. His parents had died in an accident. He was combative, rebellious, the opposite of a pacifist. The priest thought it would be a good idea for both of us to work through our scut together.
And was it?
At first, not really. He was a pain in the butt, but over time we came to rely on each other. Thanos had taught me how to meditate in the functional sense, but not in the spiritual sense. Like, how to work through my trauma, caring for Akan. He forced me to reflect and process, and together through mutual support, Akan and I were able to overcome our demons.
I can't picture Thanos meditating. I kind of always figured he was this egotistical tyrant.
No, he totally was. But Thanos also understood that aspects of meditation could be useful to his cause.
Like focus?
Focus, increasing overall awareness, pain tolerance. He came up with a series of exercises, fun little games for me and Nebula to compete in as part of our training. The worst part was, we didn't even know what he was doing until it was too late.
What do you mean?
Thanos' brand of meditation warped us, turned us into hyper-focused weapons. That way we were numb to the horrors of his agenda.
Killing people.
Assassination is just a different name for murder.
So how did you cope?
We made puns. Bad, stupid jokes to shout as we were killing people. More terrible, the better.
Here, I thought you just had a really lame sense of humor.
Oh, I do. But it was the only way to survive. And it was something we did together, a new kind of competition, just between me and Nebula, to see who can make the other laugh.
That's really messed up, and yet oddly endearing.
Yeah, well, even bad puns can only get you so far before your conscience catches up with you.
Wow. I had no idea meditation could be so intense.
Or beneficial?
Well, yeah, that too. I guess I should give it a go sometime. Although I'm kind of scared of what I'll find.
Who knows? You might surprise yourself. I know I did.
Yeah, maybe.
My shoulders are sore.
Yeah, Mantis is heavier than she looks.
How is she connected with my soreness?
She rode your back all the way down the caves to Goldie's place.
Really?
Would a wanton hen supply sustenance to this chamber?
He's asking for room service now.
Come get your own. We've got a full fridge.
Well, not exactly full.
I am optimistic about Peter Quill convincing our guest to fight alongside us.
Of course you'd be optimistic. You're always optimistic.
Optimism or not, we need to work with him. We need someone strong enough to keep Raker in check if we want any chance to get to Nikki.
Rodent, you mentioned the Madonna riding my shoulders through the caves.
Yep.
There was more than one cave then.
You really don't remember anything at all?
I have a vague recollection of dampness.
Yep. That would be... Caves.
Please, recount your adventures in the caves of Lamentis. I should be informed of what I cannot recall.
Well, we found you in the village and Mantis knocked you out. Then we went down the caves until we found the cocoon.
Whoa there, you missed all the best parts. Like when Groot slapped the ancient tree god. Yeah, it was in the way.
The tree fought a god. Impressive.
I don't think that's where Golden Boy went to.
He's in your cabin if you're looking for him, Peter.
I know.
So, Warlock. He's something.
Eh, not sure we can trust the guy who looked at the Grand Unicorn himself and thought, the lad looks like a reliable rascal.
He simply knows that the true evil is Magus. Raker is but an impressionable fanatic.
A fanatic with a lot of firepower.
Hey, Warlock. Open up. This is my room, you know. And that would be my cassette cover.
You penned this pithy poetry?
It's not poetry, it's music. Hard rock. It's supposed to have guitars and bass and drums.
Simplistic scriptures, as is its scribe.
Okay, what's your deal, man? What did I do to piss you off?
Your lamentable leadership allowed the Madonna to leave when we needed her talents to travel to the telepathic realm.
Mantis had good reason to stay behind. We just need to get Nikki and get the hell out so we can find her again.
Your tenuous tactics trust too much to fortune. Can you confidently convince me your meager measures may amply manage this mission?
My meager what?
Your meager metal. We stand against an adversary unlike any before. Blinded by burning, hope-fueled hate.
Magus, right, your evil twin. That's our adversary.
Before such a blaze, still a stooge may steer. But your wide-eyed wonder is merely wit and moxie. You strut as an insecure cock, uncertain of his stature.
Does that mean what I think it means?
This audacity acts as stilts on sand as the tide thralls you in. Leading must be wrought off the fullness of your yearning yoke. Will it be so?
Yes, absolutely.
Wise words, sure and measured. But be held by my bemused misgivings. Your demeanor differs distinctly in direction from my more willful ways.
Maybe we can meet in the middle then.
Yes, an oath. Will you own an oath to operate with greater aggression? To give gravitas to gravid seasons of your soul and struggle not to stand on destiny's icy flows?
Sure, man. Whatever it takes.
Then assert it.
I swear I'll be a good leader. That I'll be decisive that I won't let Manus do whatever she wants.
I stand partially reassured.
What about you, Mr. Fancy Words? How do I know you won't see Raker and have a change of heart?
Why would I weasel away?
Didn't you used to be best buds with him?
We were common company for a fleeting fallow, through which I witnessed the incommensurable extent of his sadness. He mourns his lost son.
That's why he's doing all of this. The church, the matriarch? Because he wants to get his kid back. But that can't happen, right? Magus can't...
No. Cannot.
So? We can count on you? When you reunite with Raker, that man's gotta go down.
Indubitably.
So, how is he?
Frustrating. It's like talking to Suzanne Harris at the summer dance all over again.
Ain't that the Humi girl you tried to impress with your yo-yo skills?
Yeah, and it went about as well as talking to Mr. Cape.
What's a yo-yo?
What happened after you entered the caves?
It was all moist and gross inside.
I am Groot.
Only you would find that amazing.
The cave network was huge. We had to go down several clicks.
Ah, with the girl on my shoulders.
Yes. Oh, and Drax, there was the part where you attacked us and straight up jumped into a ravine.
I jumped into a ravine.
You jumped at me, but I dodged.
How could I survive the fall?
Starpants did another one of his magic gun tricks and yoinked you out of there.
Oh, right! Peter's guns had another hidden setting.
Another? Oh, what an adventure.
I am Groot.
Did you reach Cosmo? It may be up to us to stop the church in nowhere. You ready?
I am Groot.
He's worried about the mutt. Says it will be easier with his help.
I didn't think Cosmo would let the church take over his station. But if they got the Cortex, then...
He is but one canine against the army of the converted. After Peter Quill pulled me out of the ravine, that is when you found the Golden Man?
I take it Groot didn't reach Cosmo?
No dice.
The tree is persistent. He will keep trying.
He was the most convinced we could bring you back, you know? I don't know if it's optimism or stubbornness, but it works for him.
Thank you.
why we ain't been able to reach Cosmo. If you don't answer it, they'll vaporize us.
I will handle this communication.
All yours, buddy.
Hey, old traveler. Have you accepted the truth of the divine promise?
We have. My deceased wife and daughter are with me. To thank the matriarch for her gift.
May the promise be fulfilled. You are clear to land at the spaceport.
All them bars and betting parlors
and noodle joints.
Maybe it's not as bad as it looks.
I assume it will be worse.
Raker rallies regiments while we wait, whistling in the wings.
Landing as fast as I can, Gold.
What the flork?
Great! Cocoon Boy thinks he's a butterfly now.
He is a man of action.
Let's just hope that he can keep the church busy while we look for Nikki.
Didn't think you'd be able to bluff your way through security muscles.
I am quite adept at deception.
We're gonna need more than that to get to the Continuum Cortex and rescue Nikki.
Especially with Golden Boy jumping ship. Should we, like, try to find him?
Time is running out. We cannot lose focus if we are to save the girl.
Drax is right. Let's just hope Warlock can do a bit of damage on his side.
A bit scared, bud. But we got no choice. We gotta extract that kid before whatever's inside her eats the galaxy.
I'm not scared.
I am scared. I live with fear every day. Knowing of its presence in my heart strengthens my resolve. It allows me to move past it.
Wow. Okay. I guess we're all confronting stuff now.
So, what happens if we find Goldie, but he's all beat up?
Then we place him in a safe location until we can tend to his wounds.
I think he means, what if he's dead?
Yeah, that.
Then we place him in a safe location until we can give him a proper burial.
So, final showdown against Raker. This time, you'll get him for good.
I intend to. We're not leaving here without Nikki. Just so you know, I'll do everything I can to save your girl. I know it's important to you.
I am Groot.
Groot wants you to know he'll do all he can to save your kid.
You know what? I think I kinda understood that.
Your kid sure got herself in a deep, Quill.
Her mom died, man. If Warlock's telling the truth, that thing inside her is using Corel's death to manipulate her.
I get it. Ain't gonna be easy getting her out of there, but I'll die trying.
Ready, Drax?
I am. My blades are as sharp as the rodent's tongue.
Was that a metaphor?
It was a simile.
Gotta make the Flarkers pay for what they did to Nowhere. And Contraxia. And all the killing and converting and stuff.
Just wanted to make sure you didn't have any lingering effects from the promise.
I know the evil it conceals. Magus and the Church must be stopped.
You take care of the Milano, okay? Make sure the ship's still here when we come back.
As we were leaving Lamentis, Peter Quill compared the Matriarch's predicament to that of a head vampire. I assume these are Terran creatures.
Oh, yeah. According to Quill, there's some kind of Earth people that drink blood and burn up in sunlight.
That doesn't sound like the Matriarch.
I would prefer a comparison with the Katathian Duthbar, a creature that feasts on the dreams of sleepers and enslaves them in eternal slumber.
Hey, Groot, let's never go to Katath.
Let's do this. Time to save Nikki.
Peter.
Okay. Just be cool. Let me handle these guys.
Welcome, travelers. Have you come to witness the fulfillment?
The what now?
The realization of the Matriarch's promise. The beginning of a new world. One without death, or pain, or fear. You should know this. Weren't you vetted and cleared to land here?
What? Of course we were.
How are you not aware of the fulfillment? Something is wrong. These heretics must be stopped! Attack!
Unless they send reinforcements.
If they do, we'll have to move like lightning. Hit them from behind. But what if they're too fast? We'll need another plan.
Hey! Every battle comes with some kind of curveball. But trying to predict where it's gonna land only makes things worse. Relax. It's easy to overthink when things get tense, but if we focus...
we can hit him hard.
Who's with me?
Wulthof's field!
Yes!
Must wait!
Let me in!
Slice and dice! Wreck 'em, Drax!
OMG, Rocket! Tie it down!
Here's a little song I wrote. I want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Be happy. In every life we have some trouble.
Put him through!
When I'll enjoy this!
Their healer is tottering! End his life!
Look away, Rocket! Drax! Shut him down!
With fervor!
Wackos better pray their new world comes without death or pain or fear, because I'm gonna kill him for flarking up this spaceport.
They have been very busy redecorating.
All the more reason for us to get to the Cortex and find Nikki.
Find the girl. Or we sever her connection with Magus.
We don't. If Cocoon Boy ain't around to suck it up afterward,
we'll just have to reason with her.
The
promise is to be realized here, Converted will be flocking in to witness it. Are we the only new arrivals?
We must be late.
Of the known universe, but don't see how it figures into anything.
Scott! Cosmos Tower's shut down!
That's because it's never been dark before. You do realize some of the guys shooting at us were nowhere security?
This does not bode well for the dog.
Never was the Mutt's biggest fan, but we could have used the backup telepath.
Just because the tower shut down doesn't mean Cosmo is too. Last time we were here, he knocked out me, Gamora, and Drax, and Lady Hellbender's bounty hunters, like it was nothing. You just gotta have faith he's okay.
Really, Peter? Faith?
There does appear to be an excessive story.
What we're gonna see in the marketplace.
The same thing we saw when we flew in.
Yeah, but it'll be up close. Nowhere really stunk sometimes, but...
Flark! Over there!
There's so many of them. I thought most nobodies would have rejected the promise.
Everyone wants something they can't have.
Yeah, but these crooks were suspicious of anyone giving them anything for free.
Yeah, I don't know, Rocket. Like Gamora said, everybody wants something.
The church tailors their offer to the
seems to me most of them would give in.
Or they'd be killed. Not an easy choice.
They got Flark and Faith batteries everywhere.
Just like on Hal's Hope.
Perhaps they have built another giant ray gun inside the Continuum Cortex.
To siphon Faith from multiple worlds at once? Is that even possible?
The energy ain't filling these batteries. It's moving away from them.
So they're powering something.
Sure looks like it.
I'm surprised the church was able to seize the cortex. It seemed pretty secure last time.
Wasn't half as secure as the dog thought.
The church's forces increased by the tick. Their superior numbers could have easily breached the defenses.
Well, we got just the five of us. Filling us all with confidence there, big guy.
Hey! Check it out! We got bad guys!
Lousy fun flarkers! Get ready to die!
They do not fear death.
Do your thing, Drax!
These are just grunts!
All the heavy must be the vortex!
More batteries the deeper we go. 100 units says they're tied to the fulfillment.
The priest said that they were bringing...
They can't raise the dead. Especially after we saved Nikki.
What?
They are the keepers. Of Catathian lore, this will be an epic tale.
Over here! Looks like we can squeeze through.
We must be close to Mantlo's bar. Can you see it?
Not really. There's a lot of debris in the way.
There is no way through this wall.
Could be a bunch of...
Peter!
Well, that didn't work.
Look, I'm going in.
What about the fanatics?
I'll toast them if I see them. We're the only ones that can do this, right? Clear back here, Quill. Looks like you're gonna have to yank a chunk free from this side, though.
Gamora, you should be able to get your sword in there now. Give me a boost.
Let's hope it holds.
Oh, Scott! Not Mantlo's. Look at her. This is personal, Quill.
Peter, let's go!
Don't suppose we could try tricking them again? Make them believe we're all promised up?
Not unless you can fake that purple glow.
There has been no sign of Goldie Braun since he left from our ship.
Adam Warlock.
Might be splattered somewhere across the lower city.
Or got picked up by a wandering creep squad.
Or maybe he was lying about which side he was on and is just waiting to attack us.
The Warlock carries an old grudge. Not align himself with the Grand Unifier.
I know how much you love this dive.
It was the one spot in this whole Flarkin galaxy where a guy could feel safe. I mean, except for the bar brawls and the security raids and the bounty hunters.
We'll drink to it later. Right now, we've got to keep moving.
I've been thinking about what Warlock said.
Which part? He hasn't stopped talking since we met him.
About how Nikki and that Magus thing might be too intertwined to save her.
Is that what he said? It's easier to understand Bug Lady. Hey, what do we need the Golden Boy for anyways? We were doing fine without him.
I was not fine. Magus was devouring my soul. Your memory is suspect.
My memory is flawless. I'm just an optimist.
Warlock's stronger than any of us, and he's got a pretty good reason to hate Raker.
So you buy his ripped my soul in two story?
Just saying, if anybody stands a chance going toe-to-toe with Raker, it's him. And we're gonna need the Grand Unifier out of the way if we want to stop this ritual.
Throw the meat into the meat grinder to keep it busy.
That's not what I...
No, I'm on board now, Quill. It's a solid strategy. What do you think they did with all the nobodies?
They were either below us awaiting the fulfillment, or they have been transported to Sacrosanct. Danger lies ahead. We must get ready.
They must have started the fulfillment already.
Why?
The Emporium used to...
Quiet! I thought I heard something.
Thank you.
Careful, Peter Quill.
Guy. Look down. It's an awful lot of light.
You're thinking it's the full Flarkman, ain't you? But it could just be runoff from the cables. Whatever these whack jobs are up to, they need a lot of juice.
Perhaps this is how they powered their fleet to reach Lamentis.
Nah, the Cortex could handle that on its own.
Maybe Raker's trying to reanimate the Celestial Head, bring it back to life?
Perhaps he wishes to turn it into a ship.
Bah, this thing's deader than dead. It ain't coming back, and it ain't jumping through no hyperspace.
They say Celestials are powered by hyperspace. Regardless, we must reach the Undercity to find the girl and stop whatever they are doing.
And we'll have to be ready for them to try and stop us.
The converted ones will be prepared to die in order to bring their loved ones back to life.
Which is pretty ironic, if you think about it.
Might be something down there we can use. Fruit.
Ah, the seedy underbelly, seedy underbelly. You know, they used to run a poacher's ring out of here.
Is that what that smell was?
Yep, rotting beast from MacLoop 4. Hoping there'd be hover bikes down here.
Why would there be?
No outrageous parking fees, for one. And two, sometimes you want to drop something off without anyone else seeing.
Can you squeeze in there?
Yep. Let's see where it goes.
So if there were hover bikes down here,
we could have hopped on and zipped down to the lower city. Me and Groot used to do it all the time. There you go. Should be safe.
Should be.
You ain't getting electrocuted.
Thank Flark, these boots are waterproof.
Anything?
Dead end.
And let's continue before Nikki becomes a dead end, too.
Our level of cooperation is invigorating. We have become a formidable team.
Yep, sure have, Drax.
We just one big, happy Flarkin family.
She's not garbage.
Behold the power of the light! Via Magnati!
Thank you.
Guardians of the Galaxy! Save the Believers and alert the Grand Unifier! The Republic must not be stopped!
That's it! We finally snapped!
Amora! Wait for us!
Stick it to her, Groot!
That was, weird, Gamora! You okay?
Must be a doll thing, I don't know!
Blow him up! Gamora! What's going on?
We have to protect her!
Branch out, Groot!
You won't ruin her this time!
Well, we might have a problem.
What the fuck, Gamora?
Perish!
Cowards! Face us!
Our blows seem insignificant!
He just went bonkers!
They took on the unworthy battle frenzy!
There are more arriving!
Wish we found some worthy hover bikes!
Unleash me onto these fools!
Been too long since I've blown something up!
Make your peace!
Crush him, Drax! Keep some breathing room, Groot!
Definitely not good.
Gamora, wait! Hold on a sec!
Why? So more children can be sacrificed in the name of Rager's flogged-up church?
No, of course not.
Just what, Peter?
I don't know. Breathe.
Every minute we waste. We don't have time to breathe.
I know Rager brings back bad memories.
This isn't about Thanos! It's about Nikki! And what men like Rager and Thanos do to girls like her. Like me. My sister. If I had just been better at protecting Nebula, maybe... maybe she wouldn't be dead.
Whoa. What? Nebula's dead? How? By who? Tell me, so I can find him and shake his Kratakin hand.
By me.
You killed your sister?
She is the one you saw in the Matriarch's Promise.
That's how I knew it was a lie. The Nebula I knew had been twisted into a hateful, vengeful monster thing. One who would never stop unless I stopped her. So I did. I just never expected to survive.
Why didn't you say something?
It's not exactly a conversation starter. Hi, I'm Gamora. I murdered my sister. Can we be friends? Of course we can't. How can you be friends with a monster? Why would you want that on your team? A team I actually... kind of enjoyed being on, all things considered.
Well, I hate Nebula, so I actually would have... What? I'm just saying it don't change nothing.
Actually, it changes everything. The most deadly woman in the galaxy just admitted... she loves us.
I
I did not.
You did. You said you were in love with us right after the part about killing your sister.
I said I enjoyed your company.
That is the Catathian definition of love.
Like. I'll give you like. Can we just move on?
Agreed. That's about all the love fest I could take.
We accept you, Gamora Zenubiri.
Pretty sure we're married now.
This is excruciating.
All right, I'm pretty sure we've all caught our breath. Let's say we go stop a nutjob cult leader.
Yes.
As it is, I have assuaged the threat. Return to the skirmish. This combat is short to draw the warlock's attention.
We ain't gonna see him again. No way. This one just eats ammo.
With pleasure. The gargantuan droid is also a sizable threat! I must hold on!
Hey, Quill! I think the big guy's seen stars!
I seek vengeance!
Go get him, Tiger!
Man!
Are we even putting a dent in this guy?
coming at us from everywhere!
Wish we had one of their fake chariots!
How do they have this many goo?
With access to the Cortex, who knows how many reserve forces they can bring in here. We gotta shut it down!
Let's get to the bridge. Cosmos Tower is the quickest way.
Too wide to cross.
Maybe we can bridge the gap.
We keep saying bridge, and it's starting to sound like a made-up word.
That seems long enough for a bridge. Drax?
I have been eager to topple something over.
You see that kid in the ritual thing?
I could not miss him.
You think the church did that to his head, or was the poor sucker born like that?
You should be prepared in case the Grand Unifier arrives.
I'm more than ready.
Really? A fate force field?
If we can find the power source, we should be able to turn it off.
Let's get looking then.
So, Gamora...
How am I supposed to drop the most interesting thing she's ever done?
You gotta disconnect the power, Quill. Cosmos spotlight would shine down on me.
That's it, Peter. Let's go. We need to get out of here before Raker shows up.
All right, dead ahead. Let's book it.
Now is not the time for literature.
Guardians of the Galaxy. The Matriarch has chosen to enact the fulfillment from this station. And you shall not stop her.
She hasn't chosen anything. You've been manipulating her from the start.
She is the light. And I am merely her servant.
Kinda hard to be the light with that dark monster thingy inside of her.
Blasphemy! You may have rejected her promise, but you will when it returns you from death's cold clutches.
Your pain has pushed you to a perilous precipice, old friend.
How? I saw you die.
The form is fleeting, but the foundation remains forever. Now cease this stubborn senselessness before it reaps a ruinous reward.
Ruinous.
We approach the Dark's Tower!
We still have to fight our way through!
The sorcerer protects the rest!
All the more reason to cut to pieces!
Yup! Get on the flat face, Neil and his buddies!
Make like a crab! Now it's Nova!
They're not Nova anymore!
This'll work! We can leapfrog our way back onto the bridge!